Following where we left in the last video, let me introduce you another relevant quantity in this chapter, electric potential. Electric potential is normally denoted using capital V. It stands for voltage, which is probably a common term to your ear. The relationship between electric potential to electric potential energy is akin to the relationship between electric field to electric force. Electric potential accounts only the source charge. In the same sense as force on the test charge is affected by putting the spoken test charge in a region of electric field, electric potential energy on a test charge is affected by putting the spoken test charge in a region of electric potential. Thus, in the context of a single source charge, the electric potential from the source charge is given by the so-called Coulomb potential through the following derivation. Just like with Coulomb potential energy, Coulomb's potential is inversely proportional to the radial distance from the source. That means, if you look at this diagram, all points on this circular line have the same potential, given by k times q over r1, because these points are of the same r1 distance away from the source. We learned in lecture 3.2 that the magnitude of the electric field at these points are the same. Do take note that I'm referring to the magnitude only, because the electric field S vector points differently at different points on the circular line. Now, we learned that the electric potential at any points along this line are also the same. The difference is, listen to this carefully, electric potential is a scalar quantity. It carries only magnitude. Thus, the electric potential at any points along this line are the same. Full stop. Now, this line, or this surface, if you think of this in 3 dimension, is called equipotential surface. Points on another surface of different radial distance from the source form another equipotential surface, and so on. Notice that, in this particular setting, because the source charge is negative, V2 is of higher potential than V1. Assuming that the negative source charge is somewhat fixed, due to Coulomb's attraction, if we put a positive charge at R2, it will naturally be pulled down toward R1. On the other hand, due to Coulomb repulsion, if we put a negative charge at R1, it will naturally be pushed away toward R2. In short, left alone, positive charges always move from higher to lower voltage, whereas negative charges always move from lower to higher voltage. You can verify for yourself that this is still going to be the case if we replace the negative source with the positive one. But of course, then in this case, V2 is lower than V1. In any case, as explained in the last video, charges in both cases will always move from higher potential energy to lower potential energy. Be mindful whether we are talking about potential or potential energy. So far, so good. Now let's put what we have learned so far into practice. Remember this problem? Then, we learn to compute electric field at point 1, 1 from a positive 1 Coulomb charge at 0, 3 and a negative 1 Coulomb charge at 0, 0 or the origin of the coordinate system. Now, we are ready to ask ourselves the next question. What is the electric potential at point 1, 1 due to both charges? Well, just like computing the resultant electric field, we can compute the resultant potential using superposition principle. The resultant electric potential is given by the sum of electric potentials from individual sources. The electric potential from the positive source is given by the following, using Coulomb's potential equation. And so is the potential from the negative source. Take note that the negative sign here came from the negative source charge. Finally, the resultant potential is given as such. Summing up electric potential is much easier than summing up electric field, because electric potential is a scalar physical quantity. It is as straightforward as 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Potential does not carry direction, and hence, we should not bother resolving the quantity along horizontal and vertical direction as we did before with electric field. Substituting the numerical value of Coulomb's constant, 9 times 10 to the power of 9, the resultant potential is given by minus 2.34 times 10 to the power of 9 volt. Volt is an SI unit of electric potential. It is derived from the name of an 18th century Italian physicist cum chemist, Alessandro Volta. Now, you also know where the term voltage came from. The negative sign here simply indicates the magnitude of the potential. You can say, from the result, that the potential at 1,1 is influenced more by the negative source. But it is not a reference to a particular direction in any sense. Once again, remember that electric potential is a scalar quantity. I will stop the video at this point as it is getting too long. However, I strongly recommend you to go through the next video in immediate future, since it is closely related to this video.